Alright. What's up, folks? Guess what, everybody? First of all, this is Michael once again in the wee hours on the graveyard shift. Your daily trivia question. Pour you a cup of coffee. Pull on up. Join the party. Secondly, welcome to the weekend. All right. That's what I'm talking about. It's good to have you here, folks, in the middle of the night. Been a smooth night. You know, there's elevator music playing over the speakers once again, and I still haven't found that switch to turn it off. I found all of them, but there's one. There's the one that counts I haven't been able to find, but I'm on a mission. Anyways, let's get right to it. The answer to the previous trivia question was a yellow ribbon. I don't know if you're old enough to remember this, but I certainly am. Yellow ribbons were everywhere in the early to mid-1980s because of the Iran hostage crisis, and that was the focus of the trivia question. This very simplistic Tony Orlando song from 1973, actually, years before, experienced a newfound popularity of sorts when the Iran hostage crisis of the 1980s wound up lasting over 400 days. I think it was 444 to be exact. And tying a yellow ribbon around an oak tree became a symbol of hope for the hostages' safe return. Although this era of, like I was saying, the early to mid-1980s gets the lion's share of attention when it comes to this song and the symbolism of the yellow ribbon in general, this was by no means the first time in history when a yellow ribbon, either by wearing one or tying it onto something, was used as an indication of support for absence or missing loved ones. Again, in the case of the 1980s, it dealt with the Iran hostages and their eventual safe return home. So, a little bit of history. Urban legend, and it was proven to be just debunked as simple urban legend, stated that women would wear yellow ribbons in their hair if they were taken, quote unquote, by Civil War soldiers who had left home to engage in battle for the country. There was a 1917 song I found in my research called Round Her Neck She Wears a Yellow Ribbon, or Yellow Ribbon, or whatever, something to that effect. In the Library of Congress, researchers found connections to wearing a yellow ribbon. Going up to 1949, in a John Wayne film called She Wore a Yellow Ribbon, that is well-known movie. I've included a picture of it during the insert there in the lower right. Multiple versions of the song carried over in time and were prevalent up to the 1950s, moving right along here, coming out of World War II. Okay, it all dealt with military symbolism, missing your loved one who was off fighting for the country. The very famous 1973 Tony Orlando song was actually penned and sung from the perspective of a man returning home after 3 years in prison. It's been 3 long years, I think, is how the song went, and looking anxiously for an agreed upon sign that the woman he loves would welcome his return. I think this is the song, and the legend goes behind the lyrics and behind the song. He was riding a bus home, and he was discussing the whole ordeal, if you will, with the bus driver, saying, "I'm looking for a yellow ribbon if my woman will take me back in, and if not, I guess I'm going to hit the streets, the doghouse, or the hotel, something. I don't know, something to that effect." The idea for the song was from a story that had its origins, again, going back to a story from the Army. Multiple layers of symbolism going on there when it comes to the yellow ribbon, to wearing a yellow ribbon, to tying it onto something. And of course, from the 1980s, tying it on to an old oak tree. Speaking of the military, the Department of Defense has a yellow ribbon program, which is an effort helping National Guard and Reserve Service members and their families connect with local resources before, during, and after deployments, again, while their loved ones are away. It all has its origins in that song from the 1980s, the yellow ribbon, channeling that aspect of being away, missed, and wanted in absence. What do? You tie a yellow ribbon onto something. Now, a couple of cool geek factoids. The single Tie a Yellow Ribbon by Tony Orlando and The Dawn, don't forget The Dawn. The Dawn were a part of that group, too, reached the top 10 in 10 countries, folks. This was an internationally popular song, 8 of which of those countries it topped the charts. It reached number 1 on both the US and UK charts for 4 weeks in that famous April month of 1973. The famous song has been covered many, many times over by multiple artists, to include Dean Martin, Ray Conniff, Jim Nabors. Check some of these names out. Bing Crosby, Perry Como, Frank Sinatra, Freddie Fender. The great country singer Freddie Fender did a Spanish version of the song. I thought that was pretty cool. And the Muppets even did a version of the song on the Muppet Show. I guess Kermit was missing Miss Piggy. And so he, or Miss Piggy was missing Kermit. Something, I don't know. Somebody tied a yellow ribbon on in the Muppet Show and sang the song. Okay, so there you go. I'm wondering if you're old enough to remember the yellow ribbons of the 1980s and the Iran hostage crisis. Iran hostage crisis has been focused on previous trivia questions, but I am definitely old enough to remember this. There were yellow ribbons everywhere, and it's strange. I don't know why I have such very distinct memories of this era in particular. I remember gas shortages, waiting in line with my dad to get gas, the era of Jimmy Carter transitioning into over to Ronald Reagan. I definitely remember the Iran hostage crisis. I remember this song. It was everywhere on the radio. We played it at school. We played it at meetings, Boy Scout meetings, and it was just all over the place. And I certainly remember yellow ribbons being tied all over the neighborhood for sure. All right, folks, check this out. Let's get ready for the weekend. I think it's going to rain today. I think it's going to be pretty strong storms coming through, too. But it'll clear up, and it'll go on, and life will go on for sure. So, but let's get the weekend started with a brand new trivia question. And then this is totally cool trivia question. Check this out for April 22nd. On this day, in 1978, this not quite real and not quite fake musical creation of Saturday Night Live cast members makes their debut in a musical sketch and went on to gain further fame after spawning a Hollywood film of the same name in the 1980s. They were on a mission from God. Have a good weekend, folks. Enjoy yourselves. Shame on you for not knowing this trivia question. I'll see y'all next time. I'm gonna go get me 4 fried chickens. Peace out, folks.